Hey YouTube, Tutu UK back again for what will probably be the last video of this year, probably. Yeah, it's just winding down a little bit. Got Christmas coming up, as we all have, so trying to save a bit of money actually. So this episode really is, well, bulk of it's probably actually trades and a bit of eBay. Some very kind gifts once more off a couple of YouTubers. So without further ado, I shall crack on with them. So first up is from a guy I've been following for a while now on YouTube, Stefan, over in Sweden, Retro Swede, and he picks up some amazing stuff. He always used to be behind the camera, then he obviously appeared in front of the camera, and yeah, really good videos. I mean, he gets some cracking stuff, and I've seen some of his videos when he's gone to collect stuff in Sweden. I mean, that's proper weather, that's proper snow and stuff, so yeah. So Stefan, Retro Swede, very kindly sent me a message asking if the sort of manual list that I've got is still outstanding, you know, or, you know, anything on there that I still, that I picked up that I hadn't updated. So he's very kindly sent me two manuals that I do need. So little note. So, hi Stuart, here are the manuals agreed. Hope to see that you complete your Master System collection soon. Stefan, Retro Swede, mate, so do I. I don't know how long it's going to take, to be honest. I'm in no rush, like I said before, I'm in no rush. It'll take as long as it takes. I might drop lucky a couple of times, you never know. But these all help, because obviously it just means, you know, it's one less thing I've got to try and dig out. And manuals, like I said before, at the right price, for a game, I would expect to have a manual. Given some of the ones that I need now, I'd gladly take them, less than manual anyway. But enough waffle. So two manuals that Stefan sent me is Battle Outrun and Dead Angle, which is in very good condition. So mate, absolutely superb, really do appreciate them. So that's that one done. Then the next one is off the back of a kind of request, I suppose, that I did in the last pickups, where I picked up a couple of them quite rare Master System games. My mate Alan, Mewtwo, very kindly waded in and helped me out with a couple of just make do, if you want. I know it sounds the wrong word, but make do covers for the two games. So again, a note from Alan. Hi Stuart, he apologises for the poor quality of the prints, but there'll be a stop gap anyway, which is exactly what I was trying to get at. I'll probably put it wrong, come across wrong on the video. You know, I wasn't expecting sort of, you know, industrial quality print off or anything like that. So Alan, again, like I say, YouTube never ceases to amaze me. Two print offs, Streets of Rage 2 and Boogie Run for me. So they will go into, I would have put them into a case, but I wanted just to show people them, kind of, you know, what it sent. They will go into a couple of donor cases I've got there. And it just keeps the games a bit tidier. Yeah, I know some people don't agree with it, but literally these are stop gaps, you know, with a view to getting, you know, potentially a full copy. But I mean, that game there alone, I mean, at the minute there's some Egypt on eBay selling for £200, I think. Was it £200 or was it, no, £1,000. I can't remember now. I think it might be £999. I don't know, it's some stupid figure. So yeah, but Alan, really do appreciate them, mate. It just makes them look a bit nice on the shelf, so I can shout them once they've ever loose cards, that's all. Whew, right. Next trade that I did with my mate Duncan, again, Woolly Weeble. I'm not sure if he's got a bottomless attic or pit or whatever. I don't know where he seems to be pulling these games from. But we did another trade. Like I said before, he's really into his Game Boy. So, I mean, I've got a fair amount of Game Boy stuff. Game Boy, Game Boy Advance, the colours and, you know, the variations in between. It's not something that I actively collect for. It's just what I picked up from the car boot. I've seen it. Well, it looks quite good. It's a good price. I'll take it. So, I'm kind of toying now, because obviously Duncan has very kindly sent me quite a few games that I'm sort of veering towards on the Super Nintendo. Sort of veering, you know, thinking more, maybe slimming down that collection and perhaps, you know, doing a trades video saying, these are all the games I've got, anyone who's interested, drop me a PM, and just try and sort of whip them down that way, because the handhelds are nice to have, but it's not something that I'm, like I say, I'm actively collecting for. Let me just grab my coffee, because I'm a bit dry here. Alright. So, yeah. Ooh, it's better. So I sent Duncan the outstanding IOU, and he's quite happy with what I sent. He picked what he wanted, so he's happy with that. And then he sort of said he's found a couple more of the items. Would I be interested? Of course. So I owe him for these now as well. So I seem to be completely indebted at the minute. So I'm gonna, like I say, Duncan, I will have a scan through them loose carts and send you a list. Anything you know, or well, what he said was I'll send. Let's start again. What he said is for me to send him what I deem of equal value, quote unquote. I mean, values. I think it's an open-ended question, because someone would value something more than others, so I'll sort something out anyway, Duncan. I'll get into the post here. Enough waffle. Right. Sent me a couple of crackers, actually, and a couple of Brucey Bones, which was absolutely outstanding. What he messaged me about, he had a couple more Famicom / Super Nintendo games. Would I be interested? Yes. So, first up is the Famicom version of Donkey Kong, Super Donkey Kong. Put this on. Now, it's weird because part of it's in English and part of it's in Japanese. All the menus are in English, but then when in game, like the text is all Japanese, which you can get by on that. It's not a problem. That doesn't bother me. And this one, obviously, I've played that one before, you know, back in the day, so to speak. This one I've never played, and I don't think I've played the second one either. And it's Donkey Kong Country 3. This is Dixie Kong's Double Trouble. Like I said, never played this one. This is the PAL release. It's a lot more open, isn't it? You know, especially on that map. Because like I said, I've just played the first sort of level or two. Didn't really know what I was doing, to be honest, because I was expecting it to be sort of, I was expecting to be led to what needs to be done, but you've got quite a choice. A bit like Mario. So yeah, and then, oh, he did send me a note, not an idiot. So, sorry Duncan, so SNES and Famicom carts of promise, found Bubba Bump, really cheap, doesn't appear on your list, which it didn't, consider it a freebie. Hope you're feeling better, Duncan. Yeah, because I'd actually trapped a nerve in my neck, guys. Pinched a nerve, trapped a nerve, I don't know. But I thought I'd been disabled, I really did, I was just like a head on the pillow, I couldn't move. Oh, he's just basically said he just needs the manual as well, so I've got two Brucey bonuses off him again. So the manual is Exhaust Heat, which is a very good game. I think it was Darren or Pete's Nestastic doing the gameplay on this, and I remember playing it before, and it's a really good game. It's a really good F1 game. So yeah, Super Nintendo manuals are awesome, aren't they? Yeah, full colour. Brilliant. And then, I don't know how he's got this for 49p. This is what he's paid for it. But many thanks, Duncan, again. It's Doshin the Giant. And it literally is all complete and in there. And let's see if I can show you. He paid the paltry sum of 49p. So Duncan, absolute legend, mate. I'll get them, I'll sort them Game Boy games out. And get them off to you. Like I say, if I'm toying with just slimming that collection right down anyway, so stay tuned for something about that. It might be in the new year now, like I say, I'm with it being Christmas and stuff. I doubt I'll be doing any more videos, because I haven't bought anything off eBay or anything, except for this last lot for a while, and I won't be. So the last, yes, this is it. The last sort of trade, for want of a better word, that I've done with a fellow YouTuber, he's done a video of it. It's Tino. Always got numbers in his name, isn't it? Tino 777. Sorry. Anyway, all the guys I'll link down below. So please check. Go and check them out. But he's in the video, and he's in front of the camera, which is amazing. So well done, mate. But then he goes on to say, I won't be in front of the camera anymore, which I thought was a bit of a shame, because I think once you've done it and you get more used to it, it's not so bad. All my videos that I do, it's always one take, unless I get interrupted, because I just can't be arsed. I'm just bone idle in that way. So yeah, Tino did a trades video. I think he's obviously explained all this. I've shared a load of stuff he's looking to slim down, get rid of, etc. There's a few bits on there that piqued my interest. Sent him a list of what I had, which is mainly sort of GameCube-y stuff, which he's not interested in, which is fine. So we did a deal for hard, cold cash, or aka PayPal. So what I got off him, again, a couple of Super Nintendo games. Like I said, I mentioned this before, I'm not going for a full set of Super Nintendo, nothing like that. It's just, if they're caught at the right price, the games that I've had before or, you know, and enjoyed, or in some cases, always wanted, then I'll take them, you know. So, first up is SimCity, and I did have this one on the PAL for hours into this. Really good game. This one I never had. And I think, was it the first one with a chip in it? I can't remember. But it's Stunt Race FX. I had a quick blast at this, can't really get used to it. So it's probably just me being absolutely useless at the game. And then the last one is Rival Turf, which is not a bad beat em up. It's no final fight, but it's not bad. Not bad at all. So that was M3. And then the last... No, actually, this thing is one more needed at this, and I can't remember if it's only got a US release or not. But the other one I picked up off him is, okay, it's Platinum. It'll do again for the minute. I would prefer it Black Label, but I'm not in the mood. It's Final Fantasy IX. It's all complete and whatnot. I'll get all them labels off there. The case has got a bit of scratch there, but that's the beauty of these double cases. I've got a spare one, which I know I have actually. So I've got a spare double rare, look, so it will get transplanted into that one. Less all the cracks and that, which doesn't bother me. They're all going to get scratched, dinked, and it's just the age of them. So, yeah, awesome. Awesome stuff. Many thanks, Tino. Like I say, guys, please go and check them out if you haven't already. Right, nearly there. Like I say, I haven't got a great deal. Right, sticking with Super Nintendo. A couple more games, I know. This is the latest one that I picked that I got off eBay. This is all eBay stuff now. I won this on an auction. I was absolutely amazed. I didn't think I was going to win it. I just put a random bid in and I won. And then it's something weird happened because I noticed they were going to send it second class recorded, which I thought was fucking odd. Why don't they just send it either first class recorded or just send it first class? And they were charging £3 postage on the cartridge. Now, I was going to do the usual and message them and say, you know, I can weigh a cartridge, I can stick it in a jiffy bag, I know exactly how much it's going to cost to fucking post, and it ain't £3. I didn't, I thought, bollocks to it, I'll leave it, because it says recorded, so that might be where, it might go to £2.50 or whatever, fine, I got a problem with that. So I waited and waited, and it still hadn't been flagged as posted. Then I had a message from them, saying, oh, we posted it, but we only sent it second class, and to be fair to them, very nice eBayers, they actually refunded me the £3 postage, so this game cost me £2.20, I think it's £2.20. And I know some people don't rate the PAL version, but my SNES is modded, so I think the extra boost, it seems to play okay. And it's Super R-Type, in very good condition. I've played it really good actually, really enjoyable. I'm absolutely crap on. It's really nice to play. I never played this when it first came out. Because I say shooters weren't really my thing. Yeah, so I did alright in that. And then two more SNES games. These are US ones. Some guys listing a load of them. Sort of bite nails, but best offers. So there's one I've been after for ages. And there's one that comes off the back of kind of off of our type. So I put, what did I put in? I put £6 for one and £8 for the other, I think, something like that. It must have been less, no, because it all combined delivery was £17 for both of these. So it might have been £8 and £7. That was what it was. Something like that. I think he did delivery for free. Could have been £8, £7, £15. £2 postage or something stupid like that. But anyway, £17 it was all in for these two games. So first one, like I say, going off the back of our type is Gradius 3. Now, I was expecting great things from this, I must admit. It doesn't look that polished, and I don't know if it's, I don't know, maybe I'm just made the wrong assumption of it, but it plays bloody brilliant, I must admit. Really enjoyable shooter, but it just didn't look as nice. I don't know, might have to tweak on the Bang & Olufsen, because the colours just didn't look that great. And same for this, I'm thinking it's probably more my TV. I might have to have a look at that. But the one that I was really chuffed to get, to be honest, I've been watching it. I've been watching it on the Mega Drive, I've been watching it on the SNES. Mega Drive one always tends to be a complete set, because obviously it's easier to maintain. The SNES one's always a loose cart. And to be honest, there's not much price difference between the two. But I managed to pick up Super Ghouls and Ghosts. Again, like I say, American version. Still bloody hard as hell. I say, I quickly blasted it on just to test it, because I mean, getting out here now, it's absolutely freezing, guys. And that's, you know, partly probably why it's all going to wind down before Christmas, because it's just too cold. Too cold. So yeah, a few more additions to my SNES, Famicom, however you want to word it, collection. So when we get towards the end of the Master System one now, I'm just sort of, I think a few people on YouTube are doing this, just picking up stuff that they actually want, you know, not like, I'm not full setting anything now. I said that I might look at the GameCube next year, we'll see. But it's just nice to be able to say, oh, I fancy that, oh yeah, I remember playing that, or I didn't play that, and if it comes up the right price, I'll take it. I say, the Famicom was always my machine of choice back in the day anyway, so it's nice just to sort of get a few more games back in and start playing them. Alright, having said that, again, eBay, I'd seen the picture of this and I thought, oh, it looks a bit rough. And then I looked at the price, and the price weren't too bad. Then I had a look at like completed listings, and it was a pretty good price, even with it looking a little bit worse for wear. So I bought it £9.50 or something like that, or £9 or something like that, and a couple of quid postage. It turned up really quick, to be fair. Couldn't get it to work. I cleaned this thing. I cleaned it up. The outside, visually, it doesn't look that great, but funnily enough, the second one I've got of this is even looks worse than this, so that wasn't that big a deal to me. It was absolutely filthy. I mean, proper filthy. It took me ages to get it working. So I did message the seller and say, look, I had to go and buy a clean solution, which technically I did, because I've had to use my own clean solution and spent about a bloody two and a bit hours scrubbing the thing to death. Finally got it working. To be fair, when I messaged him, he said, oh, you do know it's a US release, which I wasn't sure of, which would explain why when I was trying to Google this thing to get it open, I wasn't getting any answers from it. So anyway, it's the first Zelda on the NES. Now, as you can see, it's got this mark where something looks like it's... Now, I just thought, on the gold cart, I'll get that in a minute, obviously, when the gold comes off, it is black underneath. But a lot of this was a hell of a lot worse. A lot of it was just, I don't know what it was, some black shit. But all of the black crap was all in the slot as well. So I'd cleaned it as best I could. Now, the problem was, this is, and I think I did get a pretty good deal, because this is a five screwer. Now, anybody who knows anything about NES carts, it's the tri-wing screws. These aren't tri-wing screws, and I was really struggling to get them open because I didn't want to sort of chew the threads on it. I doubt you're going to see it, but if you can see in there, see what I mean? It's like a Phillips, but extended Phillips connection. So when I was trying to Google it, I don't know if you can see it any better. Because I thought, what the hell kind of cartridge is this? There you go. Look, you see it there? Look. And so I was really low just to sort of jam a Phillips in there and chew the threads up. So I was Googling it and I couldn't find any answers. And obviously all the five screwers were all relating to US games and stuff like that, which isn't a problem because, say, mine's modded, it plays it. Bit the bullet, I got what I thought was a nice fitting Phillips screwdriver, and these popped out, not a problem. But weirdly enough, when I Googled non-tri-wing Zelda or anything like that, there's no results. Now, that's all five screws are like that. It's not just like one's been replaced. All five of them are like that. So if anyone's got any info on that, I'd be really interested. But suffice to say, I had to open it up, and this black crap or whatever was all over the PCB. So again, you know, I don't know. It's got to be 2 hours with the old alcohol. Cleaned it all up, and it finally got it working. So it works. So I'm happy with that. But it was a bit of a bind. Let me just get my the Zelda, which I got from the car boot. Which, like I say, the cover on that one, see, that's my a little bit chewed up, but I mean, I think I paid £2.50 for that. So yeah, I've got the both of them now, but say that one's a five screwer. UK3. So, funnily enough, this one, because on the last one when I mentioned Mega Man, I said it was hard to tell which one's American, and Marcus X-Files said, oh, it says US and in the corner. This one doesn't say any, there's no marking on it, on the front, to sort of tell you at all that it's American. Now, the only way, again, like I could tell, was just from the back. Actually, there's not a great deal of difference in the back on the texts. That's the American one. And then if you look at the UK one, it ain't much different. So, I've got both Zeldas anyway, the upshot of that. Say, the first one's a little bit ropey, it works, so I'm not going to moan. Right, last item. And how can we finish the video without, excuse me, without one more off the collection? So I've picked up a copy of Zool on the Master System, Leicester Manual, for, this was £10 only, £7.50 or something like that, and a couple of quid postage. No manual. So I'm down to 11 games. 11 games in the couple of boxes. So again, like I say, guys, if anyone's got any of them games needed, which if they have, I doubt they're gonna want to let them go, or any manuals, give us a shout. So that's it. Like I say, I'm probably not gonna be doing. You probably won't see me now till the new year, odd-ish, unless something amazing happens and someone gifts me shitload of retro stuff, or I get a nice phone call off a, you know, an old acquaintance, which I don't think that's going to happen anyway, because money's a bit tight, and like I say, Christmas coming up, it's going to slow down a little bit. I doubt I'll be getting the Wii U or anything like that, to be fair. So I don't think there's going to be much happening, guys. So if I don't see you before, have a good Christmas, stay safe, don't drink too much. And like me, and yeah, have a good one. I might put a trades video up, like I say, off the back of these Game Boy games and stuff like that. So So there won't be many, pickups video or anything like that. If I do anything, it'll probably just be a trades video, perhaps. But that's me done, guys. And welcome to all new subscribers, because I'm absolutely rubbish and I keep forgetting to do that. Really do appreciate it. And I'll see you soon, YouTube. Take it easy.